Normally, the Melodyne algorithms work optimally without further interventions, but in note assignment mode, there are one or two adjusting screws to adapt the algorithm more closely to acoustically difficult material.
We're talking here about refinements that are by no means relevant to every file. In practice, you're likely to notice only more or less pronounced changes. But to hear any changes at all, the corresponding passage must run through the algorithm, so its tempo and tuning has to be changed.
That's where the preview controls come in. The other parameters are the screws I mentioned earlier for adjusting to difficult material. The playback type tonal is recommended for instruments producing notes with clearly defined pitches and natural overtone structures. For distorted or diffuse sounds, the better choice is complex. For the melodic algorithm, tonal is the default. For the other algorithms, it's complex. The next parameter, character, helps with unnatural volume contours. Any blurring can be eliminated by choosing crisp. If you detect any rapid rhythmic fluttering, however, the smooth setting will restore stability. Transience decides how attacks are processed internally. On the left, they're ignored completely, good for layered sound, but unsuitable, for example, for this guitar, as it softens unduly the attack. At the right-hand end, on the other hand, full notice is taken of transience. For tracks where the attacks of some notes overlie the sustain of others, the middle setting is best. The leftmost setting could be useful for effects. The formant correction parameters determine whether and to what extent formants are transposed along with fundamentals. To hear the effect of the sliders, change first of all the preview pitch. At the leftmost extreme, formant correction is off, and Melodyne transposes formants the same distance as fundamentals during pitch shifting, the way samplers did in the past. Further to the right, they move by some lesser interval. And at the rightmost extreme, the formants remain at their original frequencies. This is the default setting, and the one that sounds most natural. For notes transposed downwards, you can, if you wish, choose a different setting. Formant center determines the initial position of the formants. This is done automatically for signals containing easily identifiable pitches, like in the polyphonic, melodic, and percussive pitched algorithms. For universal and percussive, you can set this parameter yourself. Central settings sound more natural. The two extremes are best kept for effects. The melodic algorithm detects sibilants, which include here all unvoiced consonants, as well as the sound of the singer breathing, and treats them differently from the rest of the recording when implementing pitch or timing changes. If you don't want to do this, clear this check mark. For certain signals, it is worth switching on robust pitch curve. To do this, check the box and then move a blob. This will cause the pitch curve to be redrawn, this time, though, in lower resolution. With vocals, this is likely to be counterproductive, but with instruments, particularly if the signal contains ambience, this can improve the sound quality. As an alternative to moving the blobs about, you can trigger a recalculation of the pitch curve by alt double-clicking. My eyes wide shut.